Hello everyone, in this video we will learn about basics of operating system. So let us start with what is operating system. Our computer consists of various hardwares such as processor, RAM, mouse, keyboard, hard disk, monitor, printer and many more. So we need a program or a software that can manage all these hardwares, so that program or software that control or manage all these hardwares is nothing but a operating system. So simply we can say that operating system is a program or software which can manage all these hardware resources that are present in our computer system. Now let us move further. What actually the definition of operating system is? Now if you want to define operating system, then it is a collection of software that manage hardware resources and provide various types of services to the user. Now let's move further. Examples of various operating system. First one is Windows. We are already using in our laptop and our computer. Second one is Android. We are already using this operating system in our mobile. Third one is Linux. Again, we are already using this operating system in our laptop or in our computer. Ubuntu, Fedora, these are the different types of operating system of Linux. We are already using this operating system in our computer or in our system. Then after MacOS, if we have computer of Apple, then we are using this operating system in that computer of Apple. So these are the different types of operating system that we are daily using our life. Now where operating system lies? Let us consider this is the architecture of our computer system. In this architecture, the hardware resources or the hardware parts lies at bottom layer. So here in the bottom layer, all the hardware resources like processor, hard disk, monitor or screen, printer, mouse, keyboard, RAM, these all the hardware resources are lies at bottom layer. Now above it, all the software lies above this hardware layer. So the software may be a user program or operating system. These all the software, that is non-touchable parts, lies on this hardware. So if we see in this architecture, the operating system is lies between this hardware and this user program. User program are such program which are used by user to perform any particular task. For example, if we consider web browser, then after email reader, then after music player. So these all are nothing but user programs that are used by user. So this operating system lies between this hardware and this user program. So here is the operating system between hardware and user program. This operating system act as a intermediary between this user and this hardware. So it act as an intermediate between user program and hardware devices. Now next, move further to different modes of operation of computer. Again we consider architecture of computer, we have already seen in previous slide. So in this architecture, this software portion is divided into two parts. First part is user mode and second one is kernel mode. So each and every computer has two different modes of operation, user mode and second one is kernel mode. Now let's move further. First of all, we will consider kernel mode. The program that runs in kernel mode has a complete access to all the hardware resources. That means the program that runs in this mode can access any hardware resource that is available in our system. The program that runs in kernel mode can execute any instruction that machine is capable of executing. This mode has a high privilege, or we can say full rights to access any part of this system. Now next, user mode. Second mode is user mode. The program that runs in this mode can execute only a few instructions. Means this all the application programs or user program cannot execute all the instructions. So this application program or user program can access few of instructions. This user program or these programs that run in user mode has a less privilege than kernel mode. So these are the two different modes of operations of computer. Now next, move further. Why and how the switch occurs from one mode to another mode in computer? Again, consider this architecture that we have already seen in previous slide. Now suppose this user is using Turbo C to write program in C language. So this user is writing program in C language by using this user program, that is Turbo C. Now user has once finished writing this program and will start to execute this program. Means once your program is written successfully, this user will execute this program by press Control F9. Now once this user will press Control F9, first it will load that program into RAM. So here is RAM that lies in the bottom of this architecture, RAM. Now once the program is loaded into memory, that program is to be executed by processor. So again, this processor lies at bottom, that is in hardware layer. So program is at here in user program, that is in Turbo C, that is at the top layer, and this program is to be executed by these hardware resources, that is lies at bottom. So to execute this program, this user is switched from user mode to kernel mode. Here this portion is to be executed in user mode and this portion is to be executed by kernel mode. Now to execute this program, this user or this program is to be switched from user mode to kernel mode. This switch is to be done by user program by performing trap instruction. So here this program is to be switched from user mode to kernel mode by just performing trap instruction, or we can say system call. So in such a way, to execute any program, it switches from user mode to kernel mode. Thank you very much.